takes this barbell and like a javelin, as if this is the fucking Olympics, just takes it and flings it through his fucking windshield.
Story time with you, bitch.
Oh boy, do I have a story to tell you. Last Sunday was the 1st of October, which basically doesn't have anything to do with this story, but it just means that now summer is really over and I have no purpose in life. Besides it being the 1st of October, it really was any other Sunday. I woke up at about 1 p.m. and did nothing besides go on my phone and play 2K for about 4 hours. So at around 5 p.m, I left my house to go to the gym, and when I left my house, it was already dark outside, so I really just stood on my steps for like 4 hours and really cried at the fact that summer is over. When I finished crying, I walked to the gym. I got to the gym at about 5:20. It should be open. It was not. The gates were down, the lights were off, and there were no cars in the parking lot, and I was pissed. Nobody even told me, so I walked through the parking lot up to the gym door, and no one's even there. That's when I realized the gates were closed, and I was like, was anyone gonna tell me before I just walked 45 minutes to get here? Now I do the walk of shame out of the parking lot and I'm just cursing everyone under my breath. You know when you just get really mad and you just start hating everybody and you just start mentally beating up people that's walking down the street? If nobody relates to this, it's gonna be weird. Someone's gonna call the cops on me. So there's a Five Guys right by my gym. It's like 3 minutes on the way home. So I go there because in my mind, I didn't just leave my house to walk for 45 minutes. I'm not an elderly woman. I don't need to leave my house to walk. If I'm leaving my house, it's for a purpose. So I'm getting Five Guys. So now I'm in Five Guys eating and I'm viciously, vigorously eating this food, looking out the window in just pure madness. I seem like a crazy person. And now I'm just watching this guy and his pregnant wife pull in and out of a spot, and he's having trouble. He restarted like 5 times, going in and out and in and out and in and out. And on one of the outs, some guy just swooped in and robbed this spot. Now let me remind you, this is a strip mall. It has a parking lot. There's like 200 spots in this parking lot, and this guy just took this pregnant couple's parking lot. Obviously, the guy got out of his car and he was pissed, rightfully so. So he walks up to the passenger window. The guy didn't answer. The guy still didn't answer, but he didn't park to go to sleep. He had to get out of his car eventually. So he gets out of his car and them two start talking. Now I'm in Five Guys. I don't have superpowers. I cannot hear what he's saying through the window. So I'm just like, eh, it's probably a basic argument. Now even though I think it's a basic argument, I'm still eavesdropping. I'm not even eating at this point. My food's getting cold. There's probably mold going on. And now listen, I'm not really an eavesdropper, but today I was. So about 3 or 4 minutes into the argument, I could tell they're yelling. You know when you could tell someone's yelling, their fists are up in the air, their mouth is wide, their spit flying, all that was happening. I can't just walk out of Five Guys and look at these guys argue. I have to think of something to do. I'm thinking fast, I gotta do something, I gotta see this argument. So I'm like, there's a Starbucks right next door to this Five Guys, nice patio, some tables outside. That's where I'm going, front and center. Get my food, go there, sit down. Now this is the part of the argument that I caught. And if this whole argument was like these two lines, I really hate myself for not going outside. The pregnant man is standing there trying to be reasonable. I don't know why. He just got his spot robbed where there is literally 200 spots, and this piece of shit just robbed the spot from a pregnant lady. The guy's standing there like, you know, I would get another spot, but my wife is pregnant and I don't want to go that far. She can't walk. She's been craving Five Guys. Any human in their right mind at this point would say, I'm really a piece of shit. I should give this pregnant couple the spot. Nope. Doesn't happen. This guy looks the pregnant man in the eyes and says, fuck you and your pregnant wife. I need to go to this guy's anger management class and his therapist, because I don't know how he held his composure. He just looked at him with a straight face in the eyes, stone cold Steve Austin 316, and said, fuck me and my pregnant wife. Okay, shrugged his shoulders and walked away.
I don't know where you guys come from, but in New York, if you ever get into an argument and someone reiterates what you say and then shrugs their shoulders and walks away and you think you won the argument, let me tell you, you better trust me. You did not win the argument. You may think you're winning, but you definitely are about to lose very soon. So the pregnant guy gets in his car, the douchebag goes to Five Guys, and I'm telling you, I know the fight's not over. I'm not going nowhere. I'm sitting there, and I see this guy pull back up. He's in a different car, his wife is gone, and he's in work boots. And in my mind, I'm just like, it's about to go down. I see this guy get out of his car, go to his trunk, and get out a barbell. A barbell. If you've never been to the gym and you don't know what a barbell is, basically it's a dumbbell but longer. So he takes this barbell and, like a javelin, as if this is the fucking Olympics, just takes it and flings it through his fucking windshield. I'm just like, holy shit, he just flew that through his windshield. And with no hesitation, the guy walks in, gets his food, walks out, and drives away. I don't know how I'm the only one that saw this Olympian just fling an 85-pound barbell through the guy's windshield, but I was. So 5 minutes later, he comes back outside. He's like, holy shit, was Mr. Olympian just here and threw a barbell through my window? He calls the cops. I ain't no snitch. I was done with my food. I left. Hopefully the pregnant lady enjoyed her meal. Hopefully he enjoyed his ride getting pimped out, because I know I enjoyed watching it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed watching me explain how I watched that. If you did, subscribe, like, and all that good stuff. My camera's about to die, so if you notice this last like a minute and a half being really like sped up, my camera's about to die. I'm out of breath. See you guys later. Hold on. This is gonna be cool. See if I can get it. That didn't work out.